Have a nice time. Welcome back to the Algebra lecture series. In the last class, we were talking about rings. And what was a ring? A ring is a set R together with two operations, addition and multiplication, which satisfies the following three axioms. First axiom is R with addition is an abelian group. Multiplication is associative in R. And for any ABC belongs to R, satisfies the left distributive law and the right distributive law. Here we see that with respect to multiplication, there is only one condition is here. Multiplication is associative. And in a ring, there need not have a multiplicative identity. With respect to addition, R together with addition must be an abelian group. Therefore, we know that it must have an identity which is denoted by 0 such that A plus 0 equal to 0 plus A equal to A for all A belongs to R. But to be a ring, R need not contain a multiplicative identity. And suppose there exists an element in R, let it be denoted by 1, such that A into 1 equal to 1 into A, for all elements A belongs to R, we say that this 1 is a multiplicative identity in R. And such a multiplicative identity is usually known as a unity in R. Therefore, a ring with a multiplicative identity is usually known as ring with unity. Therefore, a ring with unity means that a ring with a multiplicative identity. That is, there exists an element which is denoted by 1 such that A into 1 equal to 1 into A for all A belongs to R. And if R plus dot is a ring, we know that R with addition must be an abelian group. Therefore, addition is commutative in a ring R. But multiplication need not be commutative in R. If the multiplication is also commutative in R, that is, if you take any two elements, AB belongs to the ring R, and if A into B equal to B into A, for all AB belongs to R, we say that multiplication is commutative in R. Such a ring in which multiplication is commutative is called a commutative ring. Again, we know that since R with addition is an abelian group, every element in R must have an additive inverse in R. But in a ring, an element may not have a multiplicative inverse. Suppose R plus dot is a ring, and if we take an element A belongs to R, and suppose there exists an element which is denoted by A inverse such that A into A inverse equal to the multiplicative identity 1 in R equal to A inverse into A. That is, if A has a multiplicative inverse in R, then A is called a unit in R. So in a ring, a unit means that an element which has a multiplicative inverse. We know that since R with addition is an abelian group, there must be an additive identity in R, that is 0 always belongs to R. Here we may see that there is no element 0 inverse such that 0 into 0 inverse gives multiplicative identity 1 in R. Therefore, the additive identity in R cannot have a multiplicative inverse. And suppose for every A belongs to R such that A not equal to the additive identity, there exists A inverse belongs to R, then we say that each element A in R is a unit in R. And such a ring with the unity in which every non-zero element is a unit is called a division ring or a skew field. That is, a division ring or a skew field is a ring which has a unity, that is, which has a multiplicative identity, and also every non-zero element in it is a unit. That is, every non-zero element in the ring must have a multiplicative inverse also. Therefore, if R plus dot is a ring, it becomes a division ring or a skew field if it possesses some more properties. One of the additional properties is R has a unity, that is, there must be a multiplicative identity in R. Second additional property is every non-zero elements in R are units. That is, every non-zero element in R has a multiplicative inverse. And we know that multiplication is actually associative in a ring R by the conditions of ring itself. So, if we consider R minus set 0, that is, we are excluding the additive identity of R from R. And if we consider the operation multiplication, we see that this structure satisfies all the properties of a group. If this R plus dot is a division ring. So, for a division ring, we may remember that R plus dot is a division ring if R with addition is an abelian group and R minus 0 with multiplication is a group. And if multiplication is commutative also, that is, if R minus 0 with multiplication is an abelian group, we say that such a ring is a field. Therefore, definition of field is a commutative division ring. A division ring means that a ring with unity in which every non-zero elements are units, that is, every non-zero element has a multiplicative inverse. Then if it is commutative also, then such a division ring is called a field. If a division ring is not commutative, then we call such a division ring as a strictly skew field. So in a skew field, multiplication may be commutative or non-commutative. If multiplication is commutative in a skew field, we call such a ring as a field. And if multiplication is not commutative in a skew field, such a division ring is called a strictly skew field. Now let us go through some examples. First of all, let us consider a ring with a multiplicative identity, that is, a ring with unity. Most of the rings we have studied later possess a multiplicative identity also. For example, consider set of all integers with addition and multiplication of integers. We know that it is a ring, and also there is an element, the integer 1 in set, such that a into 1 equal to 1 into a equal to a for all a belongs to set. That is, set has a multiplicative identity. Therefore, set with addition and multiplication is actually a ring with unity. Similarly, in the case of rational numbers with addition and multiplication of rational numbers, we see that the integer 1 becomes the multiplicative identity in Q. That is, it is a unity in Q. Therefore, Q plus dot is again a ring with unity. Similar in the case of set of all real numbers with addition and multiplication of real numbers. And what about two sets with addition and multiplication of integers? Here we see that it is a ring actually, but if we take an element in two set, it will be of the form sum 2 into n, where n belong to set. There is no element such that 2n multiplied by that element results the unity 1 in two set. There is no element in two set such that 2n multiplied by that element results 2n itself, since there is no 1 in 2-set. Okay? Therefore, this structure, this ring 2-set with addition and multiplication is not a ring with unity. Actually, these three examples, set plus dot, q plus dot and r plus dot, are examples of commutative rings also. Because we know that multiplication of integers, multiplication of rational numbers and multiplication of real numbers are commutative operations. Therefore, these three are examples of commutative rings also. And what about if we consider set of all n by n matrices having real entries together with addition and multiplication of matrices? Actually, it is a ring, but it is not a commutative ring, because we know that if we take two matrices A and B in Mn of R, then A into B need not be equal to B into A. Therefore, the multiplication is not commutative in Mn of R. Therefore, Mnr together with addition and multiplication of matrices is not a commutative ring. Now let us have the example of division ring or skew field. In a division ring or a skew field, every non-zero element is a unit. That is, every non-zero element must have a multiplicative inverse also. Therefore, we can say that set of all real numbers with addition and multiplication of real numbers and set of all rational numbers with addition and multiplication of rational numbers are examples of division rings or skew field. Because if we take a real number small r, then we know that there is an element 1 by r which belongs to capital R itself, such that r into 1 by r becomes the multiplicative identity 1. Therefore, every element in r except r equal to 0 has a multiplicative inverse in R itself. Therefore, every non-zero element in R is a unit in R. So, R plus dot is a division ring or a skew field. Similarly, set of all rational numbers with addition and multiplication is also a division ring. What about set of all integers with addition and multiplication of integers? Here we can see that the only units in set are 1 and minus 1, because we know that 1 into 1 equal to 1 and minus 1 into minus 1 equal to 1. Therefore, multiplicative inverse of 1 is 1 itself and the multiplicative inverse of minus 1 is minus 1 itself. And there is no other element in set which has a multiplicative inverse in set. For only units in set are 1 and minus 1. Therefore, this ring set with addition and multiplication is not a division ring. And here we know that if you consider reciprocal real numbers with addition and multiplication, actually multiplication is commutative also. Therefore, R plus dot is an example of a field also. And similarly, reciprocal rational numbers with addition and multiplication is an example of a commutative division ring, which is a field. But citing an example for a strictly skew field, that is, example for a non-commutative division ring, is not so much easy. One of the usually cited examples is set of all quaternions. A quaternion is an element of the form a into 1 plus bi plus cj plus dk. That is an element which is a linear combination of the vectors, I may say, 1, I, j and k. And how can we add two quaternions? If I take two quaternions of the form a11 plus b1i plus c1j plus d1k and a21 plus b2i plus c2j plus d2k, the sum becomes a1 plus a2 into 1 plus b1 plus b2i plus c1 plus c2j plus d1 plus d2k. And in the similar way, if we multiply these two quaternions, we have to perform the operations I into j, j into k, I into I, etc. And here 1 square must be equal to 1, I square is defined as minus 1, j square as minus 1, k square also as minus 1. Again, I into j is k, j into I is minus k, j into k is I, k into j is minus I, k into I is j, I into k is minus j. So we have to multiply these two quaternions according to these rules. Here we see that I and j are actually two quaternions. I can be written as 0, 1 plus 1i plus 0j plus 0k. And similarly, I can write j as 0, 1 plus 0i plus 1j plus 0k. So these two are actually two quaternions. And we see that I into j is k and j into I is minus k. Therefore, the operation multiplication of quaternions is not a commutative operation. So you may verify that set of quaternions with addition is an abelian group and it satisfies all other properties of a division ring, but it is not a commutative division ring. Therefore, it is an example of a strictly skew field. Now let us stop the discussion here. In the next class, we will go through some problems to have a clear idea about these concepts.